Soul. Weekdays on Blog Talk Radio. Bringing you news, bringing you words of encouragement to brighten your day. Tune in or call in at 347-826-9424. We look forward to fellowshipping with you.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to the show. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the show. I had to do a sound check because, you know, sometimes it's working and sometimes it's not. But welcome to the show. You know, just so excited about being on the broadcast today. Just today's show is Where Is Your Peace? Okay, so we're gonna talk about that today. Where is it? You know, sometimes you got chaos going on around you and you just like, oh, God, give me peace. So we're going to talk about that today. All right. So we're going to do it after we come back from this break. I want you to be encouraged and I want you to know, amen, that everything that you need is in God. And we'll get more into that after this. welcome back. Welcome back. This is Jennice Jackson or Apostle J, whatever you want to call me. Just don't call me Collette. We got to let you know what's going on in your weather here in Houston, Texas. Today is March the 20th, 2024. All right, let's see. For today, of course, mostly cloudy, highs around 70. Southeast winds 5 to 10 miles per hour. For tonight, mostly cloudy, scattered thunderstorms with a chance of showers after midnight. Lows in the lower 60s. Southeast winds 5 to 10 miles per hour. The chance of rain is at 50%. Looking at Thursday, showers and thunderstorms, highs around 70. East winds 10 to 15 miles per hour. The chance of rain near 100%. In other words, y'all, it's going to rain Thursday. Be ready. All right, it's going to rain Thursday night as well. So 70% chance. Showers and thunderstorms likely in the evening. Then a chance of showers after midnight. So you should sleep good while it's raining. Lows around 60. East winds 10 to 15 miles per hour. Becoming northeast 5 to 10 after midnight. Again, the chance of rain is at 70%. For Friday, mostly sunny, highs in the mid-70s, northwest winds 10 to 15 miles per hour. And for Friday night, mostly clear, lows in the mid-50s. All right, y'all, so that means it's going to clear up by Friday, but Thursday going to be a mess. Cover yourselves accordingly. If you're in East Texas, you know you got to put on some rain boots. You got to have a sweater in the car, and you... You got to listen. You got to be ready at all times. All right, y'all. Then welcome again to My Gospel Soul. We're breaking the yoke of bondage through the power of the Word of God. Do you know that God favors you? Amen. Here's our favor statement.
My Gospel Soul, favor statement. God favors me today. God honors me today. I am a success today. I have God's special favor on me today. He makes his face to shine upon me today. He is gracious to me today. I am someone very special with the Lord. I like people and they like me. I am flowing in God's love and others are receiving healing both in mind and body through my life and ministry. I am growing in the Lord. I am waxing strong in spirit. I am growing in wisdom, and I have favor with God and man. I obtain favor in the sight of all who look upon me. I shall have favor today with people. I will meet nice people today. I shall have good relationships with people today. I shall favor and honor others today. I will be a blessing to the Lord. I will be a blessing to others. I am a person of prayer. God is bringing me into favor and success today. Confess favor with people, businesses, your family, friends, city, boss, and co-workers, and everyone you come in contact with. This has been My Gospel Soul's favor statement. God bless.
Because of who you are, Lord,
Welcome, welcome, welcome back to the show. It's none other than Pastor Jay. Y'all, I have a dog named Yoshi. Yoshi is loud, she barks, she's something else, okay? So if y'all hear her bark, please just overlook it. She's just hearing noises and everything outside and all of that good stuff, and she wants to be a part of it, okay? Today's show is about, where is your peace? Where's my peace? You know, and we sometimes we can find ourselves in chaotic situations in our lives, and it feels like you're drowning. You try to get out, because let me tell y'all something. When I was learning how to swim, it was the hardest thing when I was trying to get up for air. I was in that water, and so I was like, well, just flap your legs. I wasn't worried about my legs. I was trying to get out of that water. I couldn't breathe. It was going in my eyes. My eyes was burning, and I was scared, okay? And sometimes in life, that's how we are. We just want to get up for some air. We're trying to get up out of the chaos. We can't find our footing. We can't. There's nothing to grab hold to. But I'm here to tell you today, the peace of God is here for you to grab hold to, so you don't feel that out of control feeling. Romans 14, 17 through 8. Let's pray. Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you for the word on today. We thank you for an opportunity just to bless somebody, to share with someone, amen, how to get a direct link to you when it comes to peace, hallelujah, when it comes to chaotic situations, when it comes to feeling as though we can't get relief. We ask you, Father God, to open up our minds, our hearts, and our ears, that we may hear the word and apply it. Amen. And be free. In your son Jesus' name we pray. So where is peace found? In Romans 14, 17 through 18, it says, for the kingdom of God is not a matter of eating and drinking, but of righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit. Because anyone who serves Christ in this way is pleasing to God and approved by men. Amen. Now, I'm going to read a prayer. It says, Lord, everyone is looking for peace. Hallelujah. Some travel to other countries and try alternative philosophies and lifestyles to find an inner tranquility. And how many of you can resonate with that? You know, oh, I'm going to go to the spa. Oh, I'm going to take a day off from work. Oh, I'm going to, you know, I'm going to separate myself from people. I'm not going to answer the phone. We search for ways to relax, you know, or to break free from the monotony of the cares of this world, right? It says some think food or wine will satisfy the hole in the heart that only you can feel. Only God can feel, amen, that hole in your heart or that place that where you lack, where you are experiencing discomfort or lack or loneliness. Only God can feel that. Boy, praise God. How does he feel that, boy? He gives you his word. Amen. He gives you his joy. Amen. Which we know joy is not happiness. Joy is an everlasting thing. Joy is a thing you could tap into to where even if your circumstances or situations is not ideal, you can tap into the word. You can tap into what God has done for you, and it will change not just your atmosphere, but your mood. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. I know when I'm dealing with chaos or something is happening and that I can't quite get a hold of it, and it just seems like it's just going, no matter what I do, say, or attempt, what I do is I look up. Amen. I get my I get my mind off of the situation. I realize that it's going to work itself out, praise God, and wherever the chips fall, God is still on my side, and he's going to help me with it. I realize that I am victorious through Jesus Christ, so what I'm going through, praise God, he already worked it out. Come on, for my good, hallelujah. And I know sometimes when we want God, when we need God to work things out, we have our own thought process or end result, the way we want it to work out. But I dare you to trust God. Amen. He has our best interest at heart. Find peace that however God works it out, amen, it's for your good. You know, may not work out the way you wanted it to work out, but when it works itself out, it's for your good. Amen. I remember I went through a breakup, and oh, it was dramatic. It was full of confusion. It was all kinds of stuff going on. My emotions were all over the place. You know, the other person was doing all kinds of stuff, and I could not. I felt like I was overwhelmed. You know what I did? Stepped completely out of it. I stopped talking about it, stopped focusing on it, and focused in on God. Hallelujah. And when I tell you God worked it out, my Lord, hallelujah. That's why I have no doubt, praise God, about my God. Hallelujah. I have no doubt, amen, hallelujah, that he's going to work it out for my good. You know, I've seen him do it time and time again. Just recently, I went through losing my job. Oh, the job paid for the church. The job paid for the art shop. It paid for the things that took care of the ministry. It hit hard, and I didn't understand it at first, because when it was happening, somebody at the job had complained about me, and the complaint was so minor, you know. And I was like, well, why would my job be in jeopardy for such a minor complaint? But by the time it just kept going. And as it kept going, the another person got a hold of it and made it more than it was. And another person got a hold of it. And, ooh, when I tell y'all, I was overwhelmed. But when I got, after I cried, you know, had a temper tantrum, because y'all know we do it, we're human. Then the Lord said, okay, that's enough. I don't need a job to take care of you. I don't need a job. I don't need you to have a job for me to take care of my own ministry. See, the Lord had to deal with me about me. Hallelujah. I had started putting my faith in me working. I had started putting my faith in the fact in that paycheck that was coming in. The Lord had to show me, hey, I don't need you to finance what I put together. Come on, y'all don't get it. Amen. Hallelujah. And it blessed me. I began to attention and focus back into the ministry, back into the people, back into the things that God had designed me to do. Amen. And it brought me to a place of peace. Come on. Same thing when bills began to pile up. You understand? I began to look at God, and God said, okay, let that go. You didn't need that. Okay, he began to show me how to manage. He began to show me how to push back on that and lean into that and counsel that. And that's how God brings peace into your life. But you first have to get in and get connected to him through the word of God, so he can give you wisdom, amen, and show you how to be a steward of what you do have. Come on. I had my phone on, and I had two phones on when the job situation happened. And so I'm going to tell you what I did. I decided I'm going to get all the phones cut off, go get me some free government phone. You know how to do. Okay. And the Lord said, and I went 2 weeks with that minimal phone service that could not help the ministry. The Lord said, okay. My son called me, say, I'm going to take care of that. Don't worry about it. Let me tell y'all something. God always have a ram in the bush. He always have a ram in the bush. You have to first you got to find peace in God. First, you got to let God have his way. First, you got to what? Let go. First, you got to understand that you can't do it yourself. Come on. And I don't mean physically. I'm talking about spiritually. Amen. Hallelujah. You can't do you. God is in control. My God, ain't that good? It says, it says, but your word tells us it's not what we eat or drink that provides lasting satisfaction. May I find peace, God, hallelujah, and joy in your Holy Spirit. Lord, knowing you, loving you, and experiencing you is true peace. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Knowing him is true peace. Because when you know God, hallelujah, no matter how rough the times get, glory to God, you'll be yet praising him. You'll be yet thanking him. And even when fear creeps in get you, because I'm going to tell y'all, let's be real, because I know sometimes the saints of God, amen, don't tell you that they get scared sometimes. They don't tell you that they get weak sometimes. They don't tell you that they want to work it out themselves sometimes because they don't have the patience to wait on God. Hallelujah. Amen. But we all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. We all have been in a place, amen, where we took things into our own hands, made it worse. Amen. And end up having to still go back and let God. Come on, amen. Hallelujah. But your peace, amen, is in God. Hallelujah. Amen. So I want to share a couple of scriptures with you. Amen. That'll bless you, praise God. Amen. That'll help you get a greater understanding, in your studies, praise God. So first, I'm going to tell you what peace is. Freedom from disturbance is tranquility. Amen. It's a state or a period in which there is no war, or a war period in which there is no war. Spiritually, amen, this pertains to there's no war in which you in your flesh. Come on. Oh, my God. Hallelujah. This war, amen, we apply this definition spiritually, is saying that for a certain period of time, amen, there's no war inside of you. There's no fear. There's no back and forth. I don't know what I'm no anxieties. Come on. Amen. Hallelujah. The war ends in you. Why? Because you know the battle belongs to the Lord. Amen. I wanted to share that with you. Okay, couple of scriptures. We got John 16:33. I have said these things to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but take heart, I have overcome the world. Amen. 2 Thessalonians 3:16. Now may the Lord of peace himself give you peace at all times in every way. The Lord be with you all. Amen. Again, that was 2 Thessalonians 3:16. Let's look at Isaiah 26. You can write these down. You keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on you because he trusts in you. That's a gumbo. I call it a gumbo scripture right there. You keep him in perfect peace. It says whose mind is stayed on you because he trusts you. Amen. Look at that combo. I can keep my mind on God because I trust it. Amen. I don't worry about what everybody's saying or what's going on around me, or the phone calls, the robocalls, the spam calls, the scam likely. Come on. I don't worry about none of that because I got my mind stayed on him. My God. Hallelujah. I heard a songwriter say, I woke up this morning with my mind, hey, stayed on Jesus. I woke up this morning with my mind, oh Lord, stayed on Jesus. I woke up this morning with my mind, stayed on Jesus. Hallelujah. say hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. And that's how you got to be. Amen. Wake up. Amen. And say, Lord, I give it to you. When it try to creep in and get you all discombobulated, say, Lord, I give it to you. I trust in my eyes on you. What you need me to do, God? What you need me to do today, God? Let me focus in on what you need me to do while you handle my business. He say, amen. Seek ye first the kingdom of heaven and his righteousness. Amen. And all these other things, he going to take care of it. Amen. Hallelujah. Look at this. Matthew 5:9. Write that down. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Amen. John 14:27 says, peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let them be afraid. Amen. So I'll just read the other scriptures, praise God. Philippians 4:6, which we all know that one about anxieties. Romans 12:18, amen. And Colossians 3:15. Great, great scriptures to study, amen, and allow God, amen, to teach you, amen, to teach you how to trust him, amen. Yoshi trying to get, come here, Yoshi. Yoshi trying to get all out of the way, amen. We trust, amen, hallelujah. I trust, praise God, that you heard a word today, amen, that will grab a hold of you, amen, and teach you, amen, how to let go and let God, amen, hallelujah, and let the peace of God, amen, get so ingrained in you, praise God, that even when folks start trying to complain, amen, you'll say, hold on now, I trust God, amen, don't care, I don't mind what it looked like, amen, hallelujah, or what it feels like, because sometimes our feelings, praise God, get us, amen, all messed up, praise God, and anxious and doing things that we don't need to do. We don't need to get in God's way, praise God, amen. God is capable, praise God, amen, of handling it, of handling whatever it is that the enemy throws at you, amen. Hallelujah. We're going to take a break. Amen. And after the break, praise God, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about some things that we have coming up, and then we're going to sum it up. How about that? Amen. Glory to God. We're going to, let me see, we're going to play a little bit by Katie Brown, Without Faith.
With God, you can do all things. They say the just shall live by faith. Well, I can't see it any other way. God, please, by our faith in Him. In Him.
Without faith,
yeah.
It's impossible to please Him.
For He
The harvest is ripe, but the laborers are few. Amen. Get your reward. That's just, listen, I could not have said it better today. I mean, you know, myself. Listen, it's important, praise God, that you put God first. A lot of the battles that you are having and you're feeling defeated about is because you have not put him first. Put him first. And sometimes now get this. And sometimes we think we can compartmentalize God. We can put God, amen, at the church. We want to put him, we want to put Jesus Christ, God, we want to put him, you know, on our children. Oh, we sick Jesus on our children. We want to put, but in some areas of our life we leave God out. But let me tell you the harsh truth. Amen. Then that means that he is not the head of your life. You are. Amen. Because you have stepped in a position where you say, I want to control. I want to put you where I want to put you. Amen. Hallelujah. And that's, you know, and God is God about free will. Amen. He wants you to surrender. Amen. To him so that he can bless your life. Hallelujah. He can give you that peace that passes all understanding, including yours. Look, the peace is so good in God to sometimes you don't even know how you made it through. Amen. Dancing and praising God and still telling people how good he is. Amen. Other people look at your situation, they looking at it and they saying, man, I would have been a wreck, praise God. Hallelujah. So I'm here to encourage you today. Praise God. Look, let go. And let God. Now, I want to encourage you all to please come out and join us on Sunday mornings at 8389 Alameda Road, Suite H2. Okay? If you're in Houston, Texas, come on out. I'm out there with Out the Box Ministries. We have Eagles United. We have partnered with this man of God, and we are lifting up the mighty name of Jesus. It's at 10:30. Every Sunday morning, okay? Come on out, amen, and have church with us. It's going to be, amen, a blessing. We look forward to loving on you and hugging on you. If you ain't hugging right now, you're wearing masks, we got enough space for you, amen, as well. To come, amen, hallelujah, and get your praise on, hallelujah, fellowship. Amen. And I'm telling you, have a good, good time in the Lord. We love you here in My Gospel. So I want you to remember that without faith, it's impossible. But with God, all things are possible. Who cares? God cares.
My Gospel Soul. Weekdays on Blog Talk Radio. Bringing you news. Bringing you words of encouragement to brighten your day. Tune in or call in at 347-826-9424. We look forward to fellowshipping with you.